So a bunch of our friends keep asking us the same questions over and over. Why'd you get married? We don't know either. Why did you elope? So Paul and I both answered a set of questions separately. We haven't even seen each other's answers yet. And we're going to cut it together in a video and tell you all of our answers. It was a symbolic marrying of his fingers.
No, just cutting them together. This is the best take we had.
Yeah, pretty much.
So the first question, how did we meet? We met, I think she approached me through Twitter. This is one of those weird things where I don't really remember exactly how we met. But I remember we met up the first time. I'm almost positive it was through Twitter. Should probably know the answer to that, shouldn't I?
So we met via Twitter, actually. We both had mutual friends that we knew in person. And every time I would go to these friends' house, they would say, oh, we invited Paul, but he didn't show up, or he doesn't want to hang out with us, or something like that. And so I decided to make it my mission to meet this elusive man.
Which leads very nicely to the second question, which is, what was our first date like? Our first date, we met up at Jimmy John's, and she's going to claim that I didn't look at her the entire time. She's full of it. Don't listen to that.
Paul was so nervous that he made eye contact all of two times. We met for lunch at Jimmy John's.
She was super personable. One of the friendliest people in existence. Made me smile the entire time. And just overall just made kind of an amazing impression on me.
And so I had just finished teaching a class, and he was done for work in the middle of the day. And so we met up and both got vegetarian sandwiches. I remember that. I'm not a vegetarian. Neither is he. We both got vegetarian sandwiches. And we sat next to each other. Jimmy John's has like this little bar with a big wall window. And so we both kind of sat on the bar, sitting next to each other. And I think that helped for the fact that he did not make eye contact with me more than two times total the entire date. I remember finding it charming that I made someone so nervous. He kind of shook. He still kind of shakes. And it was charming. He gave me a side hug to say bye. And I remember thinking, aw.
How long have we been dating? It's kind of a weird question, too. We've been dating, I think the official answer is we've been dating on and off for like 3.5 years. We've known each other for 3.5 years.
We've kind of been on and off dating for 3.5 years since we first met. But I never once would have called him my boyfriend, and I don't think he would have ever called me his girlfriend.
She tried to pawn me off on at least 3 different women. But somewhere along the way, we both kind of realized that we were the right person for each other. Which is awesome for a when did you know? When did I know? This one's really, really easy for me. Sarah and I, again, dated on and off a bit for quite a while. But when I moved to Washington in November of 2013. Overall, I was moving somewhere brand new, which is wonderful. Moving for a huge career opportunity, which was amazing. Going on all these big adventures, and I had like one big regret. And that was realizing I had really, really goofed up in not finding a way to make her part of my life. Or a bigger part of my life, I should say. And it was that like kind of overwhelming sense of regret that really helped frame everything up for me.
I knew that Paul was the one for me when I realized that the person that I wanted to talk to about my day or share my exciting news or when something funny happened, who I wanted to tell, was Paul. The person that I always wanted to share all of my excitement with was him. And the person that I wanted to be my biggest support system was him. He has always been one of the biggest support systems in my adult life. And it's been overwhelming, I guess, the amount of evidence that I should have seen that he's the perfect man for me.
So how did he propose?
Propose?
How did he propose? Via text. No, we, Sarah and I remained in pretty constant communication after I moved via text. And we got to talking about it, and I brought up, you know, hey, we should just get married. And she wasn't opposed to it. And she thought it was a joke. And she's going to claim she thought it was a joke, at least.
I got a text message saying, marry me. And I said, ha ha ha. No. And he said, no, really. Marry me? And I said something like, I'm thinking about it. And then again, the next day, he would say, marry me. And I thought, that sounds like fun. And the more we got to talking about it, the more I realized that the man that I wanted to spend the rest of my life with was the Paul Hagen.
I offered to propose, nice and officially, in front of family and friends, if she'd like. She was not having any of it. I'm saying I'm a lot. Sorry, dear. So why did we elope? This one's really easy. We didn't feel like dealing with all of the kind of mess surrounding weddings.
So we didn't have to have a wedding.
So we just went with, hey, that wedding thing, we should just do that.
Both my parents, they're married. My parents eloped in Hawaii. And so I've always thought it'd be kind of a fun tradition. And when we decided we wanted to get married, you know, I come from this family that is huge. My mom comes from a family of 6 kids. My dad comes from a family of 7. So I have aunts and uncles till kingdom come. Paul has 1 aunt and 1 uncle. So I have this massive family. We're very loud. We're all in the Northwest. Paul's family is small and less overwhelming. I'm just guessing. but we're a lot to handle in the Lake Lori clan. So I just kind of, you know, thought instead of a celebration of Sarah and the man she's marrying, which is what I felt like a wedding would have been, we decided to have a ceremony in Maui on the beach without shoes and have it just be us. And it was a really special moment.
Tell me about your wedding. So about the wedding. So the wedding was super nice. We went down to a beach in Maui and got married down there with pretty much me, Sarah, the officiant, wedding photographer, and the wedding planner. We went down, we did a little bit of photography beforehand, wearing our chucks, and then did barefoot in the sand on the beach at sunset. The officiant was just absolutely wonderful. He seemed very authentic. Seemed very into things. It wasn't just another ceremony for him. He was actually getting married in a year from the day of our wedding. So our first anniversary will be his wedding day. And so we'll make sure to send him something. So we went through kind of the typical ceremony thing. We read our vows to one another, and the officiant, the wedding planner, and the photographer all stepped away. So it was just me and Sarah saying our vows to one another.
Our wedding was perfect. I got to look into my best friend's eyes and tell him that I'm so grateful and so lucky to be sharing my life with him.
Neither of us cried. We definitely laughed. That was kind of another standout, is that the folks at the wedding said that we were awfully fun, and this was their one of their favorite weddings ever.
Besides the wedding vows that are traditional, which we did, we also decided that we wanted to write our own vows. And Paul was kind of insistent on this. And again, I'm pretty laid back. I didn't really have anything that I really wanted other than a good photographer and a wedding in Maui on the beach. And so we decided to write our own vows. And Paul cut me off in the middle of mine, which for anybody who knows Paul is not surprised whatsoever, made a sassy comment. It was amazing because our wedding planner and our photographer was walking around the whole time. Our wedding planner was kind of in the underneath the tree watching. And so it was us and our officiant. And then as soon as it was time for us to say our own vows, the officiant moved and kind of hid behind the tree, and it was just us. And it was this really powerful moment of looking into my almost husband's eyes and getting to share that moment with him and have it be just us and the sun and the sand and just the presence of all of the people that loved us, but it still being us. It was really special.
We exchanged rings. That was actually the first time I'd seen mine. What? Which was super exciting. And
it was a little hard to put a ring on Paul's finger because he got stung. I don't know if stung's the right word, but he put his hand in a sea urchin the morning of our wedding. So when it happened, there were kind of spikes coming out, but he was able to kind of pull off and out most of the spikes. So his wedding ring finger had a little bit in there, but it wasn't as puffy as some of the other fingers. I'm sure that at some point there's going to be photos of him going, as I'm putting on the wedding ring. But it was a really sweet moment. And it was the greatest wedding that I could have ever imagined. Put them in my dreams.
The last questions are, I got insistent on having this one in here. The why Sarah? So I'm fidgeting because she makes me smile. So I have not met somebody. I've met people who are happier than Sarah, but they were like cartoon characters where I felt like maybe they were covering up something with their laughter or faking it. I've also met people who I enjoy being around, but maybe aren't as happy. Maybe they're very cynical or kind of sad. And Sarah's that rare combination of both, where she's like this amazingly happy person who brightens my day whenever she's around, and it's always energizing and amazing to be around her. I can't think of anybody who I like better. She's just pretty much my favorite person in existence, so the whole idea of having a lifetime of adventures with her is kind of an amazing thing.
So everybody knows Paul as this witty, hilarious man who occasionally gets in trouble for running his mouth and saying things that are inappropriate. But I don't think a lot of people know the heart that he has. He is the most driven, supportive, caring man that I've ever met, and he inspires me every day to be even half of what he is. He's so thoughtful and so appreciative of life, so optimistic and positive and really sassy, which works really well for me. Paul is the man of my dreams, and I am so lucky to be Mrs. Hagen.
Out of the tree of life, I just picked me a plum. You came along and everything started in to hum. Still, it's a real good bet, the best is yet to come.